want to start by telling you something that you might be surprised to hear me say. Homeschooling is not the right option for everyone. It doesn't mean more people shouldn't consider it, however. Welcome to This Is Homeschooling. I'm your host, Blair Lee, and in this episode, I will be talking about homeschooling as an option to help you determine if it's the right choice for your child. Time to normalize secular homeschooling as a legitimate option with significant benefits that other educational paths don't offer. The misconceptions about secular homeschooling show gross misunderstandings about how and why we choose to homeschool and what the educations of our children look like. Before I go into detail, let's start with a snapshot. There's simply no one truth for the education of all or even most homeschooled children. That's because, unlike traditional school, homeschooling's not focused on what's best for a cohort. Instead, it focuses on optimizing learning for each individual student. That means each child's education looks different from that of other learners. This distinction has big implications for a homeschooled learner's education. So let's get started and explore 10 compelling reasons why homeschooling might be an option you should consider. Homeschooling is a good option if you want to personalize your child's learning. Think back to when you first laid eyes on your child. You knew you were looking at a unique individual who had never walked on the face of this earth and never will it again. It's our thoughts and actions driven by our brains that make us who we truly are. If you want to provide an education designed to honor your child's unique intellect, homeschooling is a good choice. When working directly with the child, the focus naturally shifts to individual learning outcomes and how a learner accesses and processes information. Educational decisions are made based on their effectiveness for each child. This results in personalized learning designed to meet each child's academic needs. This tailored experience focuses on a learner's strengths, challenges, and interests, optimizing learning to benefit the student. Children receive one-on-one teaching, ensuring immediate feedback and personalized support. Additionally, homeschoolers can explore interests deeply and incorporate real-world experiences, connecting academics to everyday life in meaningful ways. Homeschoolers believe this is the best way to foster a love of learning. Homeschooling is a good option if you want to provide your child with a higher quality of education. The personalized attention and customized learning plans homeschooled students receive contribute to their academic success. Homeschoolers are deeply invested in and connected personally to each child's learning outcomes, consistently teaching directly to a student's level. If a learner doesn't understand something, there's no arbitrary timeline. They get the time and scaffolding they need. Alternatively, if a learner can move quickly through lessons, they do. Focusing on optimizing learning leads to innovative approaches. The high investment homeschoolers have in the timely evidence about learning outcomes functions like boots on the ground, where home educators are constantly innovating to best meet their child's academic needs. In addition to reading and math, children in the secular homeschool community get more science that's cohesive and comprehensive that include hands-on labs. They get history that's honest about events, including accurate information that normalizes the history of all communities. Other courses like art, computer science, and critical thinking are also taught. The bottom line is, if you think something's important to teach and you homeschool, you teach it. Homeschoolers can choose the best fit materials and programs to optimize for each child, ensuring a higher quality learning experience. By selecting the most appropriate resources, we continuously adapt and enhance the educational journey for our children. Homeschooling is a good option if you need to make accommodations for your child. Homeschooling is often a superior option for kids who need accommodations due to its flexibility and individualized approach that optimizes learning for each child. Now, this could easily be in the category of personalized learning. I separated it to emphasize the benefits when accommodations are made in a way that's a natural part of learning. Doing this minimizes stress and anxiety, fosters a more positive and supportive learning experience that benefits a child's mental health. The customized learning pace and style make it easier to meet every child's unique needs and abilities. As homeschool families select the best fit materials and programs, they can incorporate specialized resources and assistive technologies that may not be available in traditional schools. The one-on-one attention ensures that a child's specific accommodations are consistently and effectively met, and that the home setting is free from the distractions and pressures of a traditional classroom. Homeschooling is a good option if you want to incorporate a holistic philosophy for learning. Because we spend a lot of time with our learners, there's a vested interest in mentoring students to become more skilled at the act of learning and to see themselves as lifelong learners who have a personal connection to their acquisition of knowledge and learning skills. If you believe that's important, homeschooling might be a good choice. As a part of this, homeschoolers use a holistic approach that emphasizes the growth of the whole child, integrating academics with emotional, social, and physical development for a well-rounded education. This approach fosters resilience and adaptability, helping children navigate and thrive in various life situations. Many of us intentionally weave in learning skills, such as metacognition and using all primary learning modalities to become multimodal learners. Homeschooling lends itself to intentional work on developing executive functioning skills, where there is regular practice in real-world scenarios to help students internalize these skills, making them more proficient in managing their responsibilities and achieving their goals. This holistic focus not only enhances academic performance, but also promotes self-awareness and independence, making children better equipped to develop effective strategies for lifelong learning. Homeschooling is a good option if you believe in a journey-focused approach to learning. Have you ever noticed how learning is often treated as a ticket? Third grade's a ticket to fourth grade, eighth grade's a ticket to high school. The ticket mentality changes naturally when the person planning and implementing a student's education cares as much as parents do about children's long-term success. In this environment, it's inevitable that learning is viewed as a continuous journey where each step contributes to overall development rather than focusing solely on achieving specific milestones or grades. This journey-focused approach often extends to cross-curricular connections, using project-based learning and unit studies to integrate subjects in a way that better represents how work and knowledge sharing occur in real-world scenarios. Homeschooling often includes experiential learning, incorporating hands-on, real-world work that makes learning relevant and engaging, helping students apply their knowledge in practical situations. If you believe in this journey-focused approach, homeschooling might be an option worth exploring. Homeschooling is a great option if you want to opt out of standardized testing. The traditional education system, at least in the U.S., generally places a heavy emphasis on standardized testing, creating a high-pressure environment that can prioritize test scores over learning. Additionally, a substantial amount of classroom time and even some homework time is spent learning to take tests rather than focusing on important topics, you know, like science and history. Homeschooling offers an alternative that focuses on comprehensive and authentic evaluation methods. Homeschoolers can use diagnostic and assessment tools thoughtfully, not as the default measure of success. Because of the much smaller classroom size for homeschoolers, generally only 1 to 3 students, it's more manageable to use a learner's prior work as an effective diagnostic and a more accurate reflection of a child's learning. This helps home educators tailor teaching to honor what a student should be working on next. I call this teaching children a page width above where they are. Removing the pressure of high-stakes testing leads to a less stressful and more impactful educational experience, especially for children who experience test anxiety. If you're concerned about changes to policies and curricula, homeschooling is a good option. About 3 years before the pandemic, the secular homeschool community began to have a surge in families whose children had attended traditional school from grades K through 8, who were planning to homeschool high school to provide them with accurate and adequate history and science, or who were what we call after schoolers. Those are people who don't pull their children from school. Instead, they supplement their children's in-class learning after school. It stood out because at that time, high school wasn't a normal time for when people chose to start homeschooling or even after schooling. As the trend of rewriting curricular materials continues in many states, this surge has also continued. The changes include the rewriting of history to minimize the horrors of slavery and the inclusion of anti-democratic language. Science is another area where texts are being rewritten through the incorporation of climate denialism and the softening or elimination of teachings about evolution. Because homeschoolers choose our own teaching materials, this isn't a problem in the secular homeschool community. Book banning is also not a problem in our community. In addition, there have been changes to policies that make schools less safe for students and their parents, particularly those in the LGBTQ+ community. The secular homeschool community is a warm and welcoming and safe space for these families. If you're concerned about any of these issues, homeschooling is something you might want to consider. For more flexible scheduling and pacing, homeschooling is a great option. If your child needs more sleep, is on a traveling sports team, you want to travel when there are fewer people, or you want to take advantage of cool opportunities as they arise, flexible scheduling is a significant advantage of homeschooling. Field trips, community service, and hands-on projects become integral parts of the learning process, making learning more dynamic and engaging through the incorporation of real-world experiences. Many homeschoolers participate in extracurricular activities such as sports, music, and clubs that are easier to manage with more flexible scheduling. This flexibility extends beyond scheduling to include pacing work to match the student's rate of progress. Homeschoolers can adjust the pace of learning to match their children's individual needs, ensuring they receive the time, scaffolding, and mentoring needed to learn. This has a profound effect on the mastery of information. I always tell parents, if a child's rate of progress doesn't match the schedule is the problem, not the child. Homeschooling is a good option if you want to provide your child with a safer learning environment. Feeling safe while being asked to learn has a big impact on a child's ability to learn. If this is a concern for you or your child, homeschooling offers significant advantages. Homeschooling eliminates many of the risks associated with peer pressure and bullying. For neurodivergent students, homeschooling provides a haven where students can learn in an accepting and personalized setting. Homeschooling also lessens concerns about gun violence. The reduced exposure to stressful environments, high-stakes testing, and negative social interactions contributes to overall well-being for homeschooled learners, reducing mental and medical health concerns. If you want to promote stronger family bonds, homeschooling is an option you should look at. One of the most significant and beautiful things that happens for homeschoolers is how much closer we become to our children. The consistent presence and involvement in a child's education leads to lifelong bonds. Homeschoolers come to a deeper understanding of who their children are and how their unique and profound intellects work. The nurturing learning environment fosters a sense of security and trust, making children feel valued and supported. The shared experiences of learning together, exploring new topics, and engaging in projects enhances the relationship between educator and children. Enriching activities such as field trips, hands-on projects, and community service can become family endeavors that promote academic growth and encourage open communication and mutual respect. That doesn't mean homeschooling is always the best option. If you're considering homeschooling, here are 8 things you want to consider to figure out if it's the right choice for you and your child. As you weigh your options, ask yourself these questions. Do you have the time to dedicate to homeschooling? It's the educational option that's the greatest time commitment from parents. Do you have access to the resources you need? Resources can be open and go, high quality or affordable, but rarely all 3 simultaneously. Most homeschoolers rely on access to a good library and reliable internet. If you live in an area with limited resources, homeschooling can be challenging. It can also make it expensive. There are free resources online, but finding them can be time-consuming, and free is often not best. Does your child need support services typically provided by the public school system? You'll need to look into what services are available to homeschoolers where you live. In some places, the only options available come with high out-of-pocket costs. If you're living separately, how supportive is your co-parent? It can be important that both parents are on board with homeschooling. Otherwise, the child's educational situation might be disruptive and stressful for them. Are you a fan of traditional school? If you or your child love your school, homeschooling might just not be an option you want to consider. What if your child is thriving in traditional school? That might make it the best option, and homeschooling is always there if they stop thriving. Is your child an aspiring college athlete? Be aware that there are strict rules for homeschooled students to be eligible for the NCAA. While these rules are evolving, ensure you understand and comply with the current regulations. How much social interaction do you and your child need? Homeschooling can limit daily peer interactions, so it's essential to have access to a community or activities that provide social opportunities as needed by you and your child. As you consider your child's educational options, you now have more information about whether homeschooling might be optimum for your child. Join me next time for how-to information and support to help you successfully handcraft your child's journey through learning. Don't forget to comment, like, subscribe, and click the notification bell.